Louisville, Colorado is such a cute, small little place to live, and a lot of people are asking me about it. If you're interested in Louisville, Colorado, this is the video for you. Let's get started. Hi there. Christy Lee here, and I am a local real estate agent in the state of Colorado, but more importantly, I am a native of Colorado. If you're new to my channel, all of my videos are here to help you figure out where the best place to move to. If that's something that interests you, please click that subscribe button right there. That way you are notified every time I have a new video. Now, as much as I love making these videos for you, I love hearing from you more. So there's my contact information. Reach out to me. We could have a conversation and we could figure out how I can help. All right, so today I'm going to be talking about Louisville, Colorado, and the top three pros and three cons about Louisville. Now, again, Louisville is super, super cute. It's located just west of Denver, roughly about 20 miles or so, 25 miles or so, and then only about 5-6 miles away from Boulder. So it's kind of right there in that pocket right there. Super cute. People are gravitating towards this area, but there's obviously pros and cons. So I'm going to start with the cons first. And so the number one con about Louisville is that the cost of living, or just cost in general, just being out there, you are 100% paying for living close to Boulder. I mean, that's really all it is. Your money does not go nearly as far in Louisville as it would maybe some of the other surrounding areas around Louisville. So one thing that you do need to keep in mind is that if you're moving to Louisville, if you're considering it, a lot of people are going to be a little bit sticker shocked, depending on what area of the country you're coming from. But on average, the average price point in Louisville is going to be, probably mid 700s. But that's honestly not going to get you very much. That's going to get you maybe a 3-bedroom house, probably built in the 80s, early 90s, roughly 1500 square feet. You're just not going to get a whole lot for $750,000. So in order to get maybe something a little bit larger, you're going to be pushing that $1 million mark. And it's simply just because of its location. Louisville has a lot to offer, which I'll go over in just a second. But to get to where you want to be, possibly, you're probably going to just be paying more for your money. So to piggyback a little bit off of the cost of living, the second con of Louisville, and a little bit of Superior as well. So Superior is going to be kind of right next to Louisville, is that in December of 2021, we had the Marshall Fire out there, and that's where 1,000 homes actually got burnt down here in the city of Louisville and Superior. So this is a big con, obviously, if you're wanting to move into this area, because there's just not the inventory that there once was. Obviously, there's a lot of homes, unfortunately, that did get burnt down and that are actively getting rebuilt, not necessarily by the same owners. Other people are buying the land and building, but it's like a very costly and time-consuming process that people are having to go about to get this done. So again, that is another reason why the cost is going up in Louisville and Superior, is just because we don't have the housing there. People are wanting to move there. There's very, very low inventory. And the third con is that it lacks diversity. So there's 83% white population out in Louisville, and then everything else is kind of sprinkled throughout there. So, you know, if that's something that, you know, is of worrisome to you, or, you know, that you want to pay attention to, just note that it does lack diversity out in this area. You are super close to Boulder, and Boulder as well lacks it as well. So do kind of note that, you know, it definitely hasn't evolved into more of a diverse area. Is definitely still, again, a little over 83% population will be a white population. All right, so now moving into the pros. Now, obviously, I personally do love Louisville. I can't afford Louisville just because its location, its price point. And honestly, I feel like there's other areas that are a little bit more cost effective, and you could still go to Louisville and still visit Louisville at any time. And that's what me and my family do. But the biggest pro, or one of the biggest pros, I feel like being in Lewisville is that it is in Boulder County, which means you are in the Boulder Valley School District. So if you are somebody who has kids or is planning on having kids in the future and you are concerned about their education, Boulder Valley School District is ranked number one in the state according to niche.com. So most people who contact me and who are wanting to be in Lewisville mainly just want to be in Lewisville because of the Boulder Valley School Districts or in their schools. So do note that it is in one of the top rated school districts in the state, which is awesome. But again, you are paying for that, of course. Another pro, I feel like, being in Lewisville is that you are super close to Boulder, but you are not paying the Boulder prices. You still get the feel of Boulder, but you don't have to worry about their prices. So, like I said, on average right now in Lewisville is about $750,000. Boulder is $1.1, okay? But you still do get the feel of Boulder because it's really close. I mean, we're talking 15 minutes away between the two, but then even Lewisville actually does have a little small town area. Its walkability is awesome if you're going to live near the historic downtown area. Within that area, you're gonna have a winery, brewery, melting pot, barbecue, Mexican, ice cream. There's so many cool things within this area that people just love it because you're able to walk there. They have so many community events, farmers markets, concerts, things like that, that people just love being in this area, but you don't have to pay for the Boulder prices because that kind of stuff happens in Boulder too. So that's why most people do gravitate. It's not nearly as expensive as Boulder, but you still gotta kind of feel like you're in the Boulder area. All right, and the third pro, and I guess you could take this a con too, depending on who you are, but it does have a smaller population. The population in Lewisville as of 2023 is just over 20,000 people. So it is quite a bit smaller than some of the other areas, including just surrounding Lewisville. It is quite a bit smaller than other areas. But I mean, you could take that for however you like. If you're somebody who truly does like that small town feel, Lewisville's amazing. Lewisville's super, super cute. But if you're somebody who really needs more stuff going around you, more amenities coming around you, or even just like nightlife, if you're somebody who just really actively wants to be part of the action, Lewisville might be lacking for you. So I would probably head into Boulder or even into Denver if that's kind of the night or the lifestyle that you actually like. One more pro that I want to add on to Lewisville is that we are going to be closer to the Flatirons, the foothills. So if you're a hiker, a biker, somebody who likes to actively be outside a lot, you are going to be right there at the footsteps of all of that. So you do have all of that right there if you move to Lewisville. All right, so those are my top three pros and cons of Lewisville, Colorado. If you have any questions regarding this area or any other area for that matter, please reach out to me anytime. I'd love to help. Remember to click that subscribe button right there. That way you are notified every time I have a new video. And then to the next video, take care.